topic for my presentation is the future of linguistic narratives in the digital age. And by linguistic narratives, I intend stories written in words. Now, we are living in a screen culture. So often I encounter students coming up, ma'am, how to read this entire book? We can actually get a plot story. But in this process, we are the aesthetic process of meaning making is also distance. And also in this process, I think so, we are distancing ourselves from making deeper connections with life. Too much of information and rather misinformation. So it poses a difficulty of assimilating and forming our own perspective, realizing what intrinsically our ideas are. So everybody knows about the story of the curious monkey. So the curious monkey he meddled in the affairs of the carpenter. So, but the basic story is that he is intrinsically very curious. And this trait of being very curious is something which we can relate to as humans also. And somehow this digital world is exploiting this notion, this idea of knowing things. Often it leads to a lot of rambling thoughts, and we are too engaged and too many thoughts inside. So it becomes difficult to actually form an idea. So with the basis of so much of information, the basic question is that have we gained any deeper insight into life? Can we, do we have the ability to live with our uncertainties and indeterminacy? We are so impatient to arrive at a meaning. But sometimes the deep contemplation, because we instantly want answers. So that makes it very difficult to somehow have the patience to live a life where you can understand the depth of experience. So it's basically a lot of information is actually making us more, less focused and losing our attention span as well. We see children so impulsive. So I basic premise of this presentation is, I think so reading long short narratives is basically, it's going to give you a perspective of reflecting deeply, of contemplating deeply, not just going with the shallow knowledge on the superficially which is available. But also, you know, with this so much of information, we come to a realization that we don't have the patience to contemplate. But what to do? There is this addict. It's like this whole process has actually made us very addicted to this digital culture. Now, basically, we can say that from a reading brain, we are moving to a digital brain, which is increasingly addled by spectacle and surface sensation. The visual performance is actually made us distant from the depth of meaning-making process. So it's basically not just a rambling mind, okay, we have lots of connections to life, but the way in which we have to learn a way to patiently contemplate and make a deeper realization about meaning. So basically, you know, we have Android phones, we can carry it anywhere. So it's like we are moving in an endless now. It's like just flipping through the screen. So it's a kind of our offline life as well has become like an online life. We are just too much engrossed in watching our phones, what's happening, but nobody is watching the steps and what's happening around. So that's why I think sometimes we need to slow down. Slow down, take a book, engross in the visual imagery of the words. Now everything, you know, quick fixes and instant gratification, we want instant answers. So somehow it is making us impatient. Impatient, we get our answer, otherwise we'll move on to the next information. So that's difficult. Now, we have lost our rootedness. And also, our focus and attention span is reduced. We come to a realization, but it becomes too much of addiction and it's very difficult to somehow outstep it. Now here we can understand why literary language. Now engaging in a book, you know, words have their own rhythm. And somehow we have to slow down to understand it. And sometimes that slowing down process, it leaves a deep impact on your mind. And maybe it also gives you a lesson that life is not about exhilaration, about speed, but also to patiently wait for meaning. Now there's this term which has been given of deep reading, engaging with words. And in fact, there was this Barack Obama, the ex-president, he talked about how important books are during his tenure because he had so much of information. So he says that I just indulge in a book to slow down, to get a perspective of my own perspective. So that slowing down, this deep reading is where we control the pace. That is the most important thing. So basically, what does linguistic narrative offers? So extended narratives demand that we slow down, that we enter the rich storehouse of language itself, that we feel the systolic and diastolic rhythm of that language in our pulse, and that we reflect on that language, making it our own. So that's all. Thank you.